St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King, a legacy of domination for 50 years. Go Fish Ontario, it's catching. They are lazy. Cold morning. There's my introduction. Right here. First fish of my trip. And it's a duker, isn't it? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. You know what? Doesn't matter. Listen, welcome back to Extreme Angler. That, I can guarantee, is going to get a lot bigger. But you are the right species. We're on the right lake, Northern Ontario. Waterfalls Lodge. Look at it. Pristine. That's why I'm here. More chances to fish for big trophy fish, quality fish, walleye, pike, big perch, smallmouth. That's the key. But for me, you know, those brown fish, I'll chase them anywhere in the world. But up here in Northern Ontario, anytime you get a chance to fish it, and where potentially there's 5, 6, 7 pound fish, and you got it all to yourself, you can't pass it. So I'm gonna try maybe some top waters first thing. If I see fish on the sonar like I have been, throw the drop shot down, tubes. I'm fully stocked, ready to go. Let's see if we can do it so I can inspire you to come here and fish exactly where I'm gonna fish next time. That feels a little bit better. Oh, I'd say, whoa, boy. That's a lot better. Oh! And he jumped off. That's what we're looking for, first thing in the morning. Maybe 4 pounder, but that's how it goes. He just slowly rolled on it, but you keep fishing it, and you hold your breath that they come to the boat. I got a feeling that, you know, with the soft bite the way it is, cold front, first day that's a little bit normal again. We'll just keep fishing, hopefully catch some bigger fish. Let's go. You know what I'm seeing here? A lot of deep water and stuff, and traditionally, myself too, I look for the obvious stuff, okay? Because we all do it, especially for smallmouth, you know, rocky points, ledges, and things like that. But when it's deep water like this, and there's lots of forage, and you see the bait balls everywhere, those smallmouth have options. If there's offshore, lots of bait, try it. You know, jerk bait, crank bait, the top water. Don't be shy to throw this thing in the deep water. If that's where the bait is, a lot of times that's where the fish are. You know, do try the stuff that's very obvious, but get offshore sometimes, and you'll get them. That didn't take too long, huh? These bass are psychotic for these walking baits, I tell you. Look at them, I can just swing them in maybe. Hey, you got it. Yeah, didn't take long, eh? I think first cast with my little walking bait. This is a chunker, right? Chunky little bass on the top water. That's what you want right there. At waterfalls, we're gonna be catching them. You can catch them too. Go on. Recover and down. See, throwing the popper back and forth. Boop, 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 KVD splash and stuff. One rolled on it, had him under the chin. First cast with that little bait, it drives them nuts. They follow it. So have backup plans. You see, I got lots of rods, subsurface, surface, morning's top water. As the day goes on, maybe a little windier and stuff, I'll go subsurface. But for now, I want to catch them big. I want to catch them often, so it's on top. Plus, it's fun. Let's keep going. Look at that big hook down there. Oh, see the size of him? Oh, God. Stay they hook big boy. Out there feeding on those smelts and stuff here. It's all kinds of stuff here. Look at him, eh? Oh, nice. Look at that. Hey, you wonder why I use a net for smallmouth? Take a look. There's the bait. Here's the fish. And that's one of the reasons I fish and come to lodges for fun. Seriously, look around here. Peace, serenity. It's just, you know, God made beautiful water up here in Northern Ontario and these beautiful fish. Tell you what, I'll put them in the box. But I mean, it is just something else. Seriously, you say, okay, lodges and stuff, it's so easy and stuff like that. Yeah, it can be, but it's fun, man. You know, life is about experiences, having fun, catching fish, meeting good people, good food, you name it, the whole deal. And that's why I come to lodges for that kind of stuff. Because man, I fish hard all over the place, public waters, and it can be tough. We all know that, no matter where you are. But you come up to a lodge, you have that experience that just stays with you forever, like that bite. And get back my breath, my heart rate, and hopefully catch another one. Let's go. Look how deep I am. 27 feet of water, I just caught that fish. You say to yourself, 27 feet of water, what's out there? Rocks, sand, etc. Nope, the bait fish. Wherever the bait fish are, it could be 70, 80, 90 feet of water, 100 feet, it doesn't matter. Wherever those bait fish are, those fish are susceptible to coming up for topwater baits like the sexy dog. You saw it, we're gonna keep at it. While the sun, wind's down, they predict we're gonna go up to about maybe 30K this afternoon. So I'm gonna take advantage of the topwater, stay on those bait fish bites, and hopefully put a few more in the boat. Look at that. Two or three of them right below the boat, right there. Up the drop shot, I drop it down 10 feet below the boat. You see the streaky fish? Let's see if he'll eat it. That'd be something, wouldn't he? Over 32 feet of water. See that? He's got it too. Oh, look at him too. Wow, hey? Amazing, man, how these fish do that stuff out here in this deeper stuff. Amazing. Look at them. Beautiful smallies too. Beautiful looking fish, man. Beautiful. Making my day, boys. Hey, look at him. He wants to spit it. He found the net, boy. You're not as big as the other one. But man, you are making my day. He's not a big fish, but we're just gonna call him out. You see the streak? I think maybe, you know, I'm throwing the top water. What happens a lot of times, you throw that top water, the bait coming to the boat, the fish doesn't eat it, he goes. And here's something, it's true. Seriously, on clear waters, you see it all the time. It's, I don't know, you wanna call it a phenomena, or whatever habit fish have. They'll go under the shadow of the boat. And you see the streak just following along the shadow of the boat. They do it. You think they're that smart? They're not. Drop the bait down, shake it. He ate it. Let's keep going. You know, when the top water's going, okay, you figure those fish are on that bait fish. They're following those big clusters and stuff. But some of the hardest smallmouth to catch is when they're suspended. You know, when they're sitting up high like that in the water column, man, they can be tough. But that little tube jig too, cast it so it's falling, rip it once in a while, just get a reaction. You know, it's falling where they are. So the law of averages, you do it enough in the right areas with baits that potentially that stays where they are, they're gonna eat it. Oh, geez. That's soft. Sometimes they miss it, hit the blind. Hit the line. See? He ain't big, but I could feel that. That soft bite. He missed it the first time. He missed it the first time, and he's small. Maybe that's why his mouth was too small. Boy, look how they ate that. Wow. Just a little guy. A little guy. On a reaction bite. Go on. It's a little tube jig. Little tube jig. My stomach, that's one thing about being in a lodge. You know what? it's great because you can go out in the morning, catch some fish, have some fun, and then when you got enough fish, go in for lunch, maybe have a nap, come back out in the afternoon. You know, just relaxing, fun fishing with all the comforts of home, like a place like this up here in Waterfalls Lodge. I'm gonna fish a little bit more and then go have my lunch and then come back out for part two of the show.
The Extreme Edge, presented by Strike King.
I want to show you a lure that I had a lot of input into the design of. It's a jointed structure head. Right here I have it rigged with a rage bug, a Strike King rage bug. But now let me tell you, you can put most any type of soft plastic on this head. You notice this head comes in three sizes, 3/8, 1/2 ounce, and 3/4. This is a 3/4 ounce. You notice that the head swings. It's a lot of people call it a swing head or a swivel head. It features a needle point, mustad hook, and you fish it on heavy line. But the great thing about it is you can use it as a search bait. And what I mean by that is you'll make long casts, get the lure on the bottom, slow grind. I call it a grind because you're actually grinding this lure on the bottom on the retrieve. And it's much like a crankbait. And you're actually, you know, dredging it on the bottom, and you're not stopping it, you're not hopping it, you're not pulling it. It's a steady pull. I basically got my rod tip pointed at the lure, and I'm winding it on the bottom slowly. When you locate the fish, then you can slow it down and start to fish it more like a jig, you know, where you're lifting, actually working it with the rod tip, you know, just like you would a jig or a tube or any other type of soft plastic. But the whole technique and what makes it great is I can go on the water with one lure, one head, one rod. I can find the fish, and then I can slow down and I can catch them. Now I'm gonna show you exactly how I fish with the jointed structure head. Gonna make a long cast. Get that lure on the bottom. And once I get it on the bottom, it's just a slow, steady retrieve. And I will repeat that, and you'll be amazed at how much water you can cover fishing it that way. You know, because you can get on shorelines or grass lines, weed lines, just cast and wind, keeping that lure right on the bottom. So it's a 1-2 punch. You can wind it or you can slow it down and fish it like a jig. Great way to catch bass. I caught a lot of fish on the tour this past season on the jointed structure head from Strike King.
Hi, this is Rob and Kathy, and we are the owners of Waterfalls Lodge.
Waterfalls Lodge is located in Northern Ontario. It's between Sault Ste. Marie and Sudbury. So you can drive in and park right beside your waterfront cottage. We offer 14 waterfront cottages with decks, barbecues, table and chairs, three-piece bathroom, hot and cold running water. We offer a chain of 7 lakes. Altogether, you can, from our docks here, you can boat and fish 4 lakes. They are all connected, and you can fish and boat through to all these lakes right from our docks. We're known as luxury in the wilderness, where you can stay in a modern cabin, fully equipped. And then we also offer new deluxe cabins, which is modern but rustic, including air conditioning, TV, and gazebos on huge decks. We offer packages for fishing, hunting, and ATVing. We have accommodations that will fit all sorts of groups.
We hope you come and join us, and you do come as a guest and leave as a friend.
Now you see I'm not whipping that way down the lake. Like I'm throwing that topwater trying to find fish on flats and deep edges and stuff like that, or looking for forage fish. When I'm throwing that tube, it's maybe just farther than my boat distance, 30, 40 feet. Sometimes, you know, just cover different areas. But I want to dissect what I see down here, little weed patches and stuff, and have a lot more control over that tube jig, and I can feel those little soft bites a lot easier if I'm just making short, underhand pitches, 30, 40, 50 feet ahead of the boat, let it fall, and I can watch the line going down, just fall nice and subtle. If anything happens, there's a good chance that Legend Extreme's gonna tell me. It telegraphs it perfectly. I can just pick up the slack quick, set hook. Very important. Dissect where you're fishing, just like fishing the whole lake. You don't want to think about the whole lake, you get intimidated. Dissect little pockets. The areas you're fishing, dissect it as well. What is it? Where have you caught fish? What depth? All those little pieces are so important to keep consistently catching fish on a new body of water. So when you go to a lodge, you know, look at the whole aspect, find your strengths, what you like to fish, ask the lodge owner, different people, where the fish are, what they're using, and just dissect those little areas. Don't get intimidated. Pick it apart and you're gonna catch them. This is pristine, look at this. There's no one around. And you ask why I come to lodges. Look at that. Is that ever fun? How can you beat it? This lake. Oh, nice smallmouth, yeah. Look at that. You got that too, boy. He's buried down there, look at that. Whoa, I love it here naturally. There he comes up. That's what you love right there. Whoa, there you go. Nice, nice. Where'd you take that, huh? Where'd you got that tube, boy? Hey, you take it down? How far did you take that down? But you throw that tube around a little bit, throw it in, doom, jerk it, doom, jerk it. It's just that reaction. It's almost like a jerk bait, but you're falling, you know, covering the whole water column vertically and horizontally by jerking it, then it fall. Lift up, and there he was. When you're doing that vertical rip of the tube jig, it's very important, your tackle. I got 8-pound gamma fluorocarbon. The water is, you know, a little tea color, but it's still, I just want those fish only to see the tube jig falling and ripping. 7-foot St. Croix, medium heavy, very important. If your rod is too soft, you lift up sometimes and feel those fish, you gotta make sure that that little lift or the little rip gets the penetration. If the rod's too soft, when you lift, he feels that, good chance he's gonna spit it out, you miss the fish. I've put the drag all the way tight for set and hook and ripping. As soon as that fish has a little power, he has some size and stuff by the boat, loosen off and let him run. But very important, match your tackle. And for me, the 7-foot, medium heavy, is a way to go when I'm ripping tubes on the edge of a shoreline drop, looking for those smallmouth that are just cruising along on sand and wood, weed. Those little flat edges, it's a killer technique. And as you can see, it catches them. I'm gonna show you something. Look at this right here. See this right here? This is the stuff they're sitting in, right there, or relating to, I should say. Real sparse little weed. I find it in Muskoka a lot, you know, Lake of Bays and stuff. And it's a real sparsey little weed, but the bait is there. Wherever the bait is, that's where the bass are. Very, very important, especially in these little back cuts and coves and stuff. You find that kind of stuff, it's not going to be that traditional milfoil cabbage all the time, but that little sparsey little grass, that's all it is. They just sit in it, wait for your bait, and eat it. Let's keep going. I'm about 9-10 feet of water here. Oh, that's a nice one. Look at that one. Oh boy, hey. Yeah, he want to eat that. Look at that. He want to eat that or what? Here you. Oh, yeah. Look at the belly on him. Look at the belly on him. Wow. Look at that. That's getting respectable right there. Getting that nice big fat mouth. Whew, he took it good too. Right through the schnoz, look at that. You can't beat that kind of hook set like that. Just a real nice little ding. And that's fun. Like, I know they're not big Great Lakes fish, but you know what? This is just fun. This is lodge life, man. Catching beautiful big bronze smallmouth bass. Let's put them in the box. We'll let them go. We'll let them all go. But that's just having fun. That's catching fish. Putting it together, different baits. And I guess they know it's almost lunchtime because now they're starting to bite. Now I'm starting to fish hard. But I mean, I'm gonna go out later on, try some other spots of the lake, a little bit deeper stuff, maybe shaky head, you know, drop shot and that kind of stuff, and just see, you know, have some variety, check out the whole lodge, the whole experience, different parts of the lake, and get ready for next time when I come back and see where I will focus on where I wanna fish.
To experience your own outdoor adventure on one of these gorgeous seven lakes, give the nice folks at Waterfalls Lodge a call to book your next luxury vacation in the wilderness. Young Steels, Ford Lincoln, Interstate Batteries, CompuSolve, Top Gun Marine, Valley Fashions, Rage Tail Soft Baits. Catch us at ExtremeAnglerTV.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.